So here is the problem which I am facing. If I go to my website and if I try to open my website, it is being redirected to another website, okay, which is kind of scam website or can be any other website. Okay, so now you can see when I opened itpanther.com, it is sending my website to some other website like click.something, and then it is further being directed to other website. Okay, so what is happening is that someone has inserted some redirection code into your website, and I was trying to figure out how to resolve this issue. Okay, so one very simple trick is that if you are taking database backup, you can just restore database to your previous backup. Okay, so let's say if the previous backup was working properly, you can restore it to previous day's backup. So in my case, as you can see, today is 19th of February, so this is the latest backup which I have, but this one is already infected. Okay, so this one is already having the problem, so I need to move on to one day older backup file. Okay, now if I move to one day older backup file, I know the problem is going to go away because yesterday the site was working properly. So it means today someone has, you know, injected some spoofy code into the website. So now what I'm going to do is I just wanted to understand the, you know, problem, where exactly the, you know, spammer has injected the code or hacker has injected the code. Okay, now I still don't know whether the code was injected through directly database or from the, you know, website itself. So we'll discuss about that later. So what I thought of doing here is I just wanted to do a comparison of today's backup and yesterday's backup. Okay, so that will give me an idea of where exactly is the problem. I'm going to run diff command and I'm going to use today's backup file and going to compare it with yesterday's backup file. Okay, and hit enter. It's going to take some time and now it is going to tell you the differences. Okay, so now we can see that these are the, you know, some of the lines which came yesterday which were not there on 18th backup. Okay, so which means there is some issue here. Okay, so from here I can clearly see that there seems to be something which has been inserted into wp-options table. Okay, so I'm going to go to the database and here I'm going to run select star from wp-options limit 1. Hit enter and now you can see there is, you know, already you can clearly see there is some other website which has been inserted in into your site URL. Okay, so now let's say if you just want to, you know, make sure, you can copy this and you can open a new tab and you can paste that URL here. Hit enter and now you can see the behavior of this URL is exactly the same and it is also redirecting you to the same URL which was happening when we were trying to log into our website. Okay, so the this URL is correct. Now there might be chances that this URL has been placed at many other places, so we are simply going to run this query which is going to give you query. And what this is going to do is this is going to search anything which begins with HTTP in the option underscore value column. So I'm going to hit enter and now you can see it is returning these, you know, four items. Okay, so now I can see for option ID 1 and 2 these items have been inserted, okay, which is the infected URL. So now one more thing which we can do here is I'm also printing option underscore name. So you can see that first and second URL is actually meant for your website URL and your homepage URL. Okay, so what the scammer, or I don't know what to call this person, or the bot, okay, so they have inserted some spoofy URL into the first and second option ID. Okay, so at this point of time all you can do is you can just update the correct URL here. Okay, so for that what you can do is you can write update set and you can say option value equal to, here you need to give your website full path. And also you need to use where clause. Okay, so we are going to say where option ID in 1 and 2. Okay, so remember we just want to update these two entries. We don't want to update anything else, otherwise the whole website is going to get messed up. Okay, so this query is going to do that. And hit enter here. Now we can see it is it's giving some error at the moment. Let me see what has gone wrong. So I think some syntax is incorrect. So we are saying update. Yeah, we missed the table name. So table name is w underscore options. So this is the correct query. And once we hit enter, now we can see it is saying that rows match 2 and it has changed 2 rows. Okay, so we are going to use this query again to check what is the data now. And if you hit enter, you can see now it has been, you know, changed to correct IP. Now let's do one thing. Let's go to our site now and see what happens. Okay, so at this point of time, your website should open properly and it should not get redirected to any other website. Okay, so you can see now the website is opening properly. And I'm still going to figure out, you know, what exactly has gone wrong and whether the data was being injected from one of the WordPress plugins or whether the data was being injected directly accessing the database, okay, which is even worse, which means that someone is already having access to the database, okay, or the person might also have access to the server itself. So just stay tuned for part 2. In the part 2, I'm going to explain more about this. But for now, if you see your website, your WordPress website is being redirected to any other website, just go to your database and scan WP underscore options table, especially for where option ID is equal to 1 and 2. And just make sure that here you don't have any spoofy, you know, URLs. So that's it in this video. See you in the next.